Ladies and gentlemen, it's the main event and time to meet the challenger from Belfast, Northern Ireland. It's Eamonn Magee.
Eamonn Magee has been waiting to enter the arena, and he's been getting a very hostile reception indeed here in this almost claustrophobic Motherwell Civic Centre arena tonight. But Magee won't worry about anything much. He's as hard as nails, this fellow. As the boys have been telling you, the main question really against him is how much does he have left at the age of 35? He's just punched me around the head as well. We've covered a lot of his fights, gives me a smile. I might be the only friend he's got in the place, but without you, of course.
Yes, he's a good fighter. He's a tough man. He's been in the lion's den before, and, you know, he's proven himself. But has he still got it? He's 35 now, coming to the end of a career.
He's still got a bit of punch power, I can confirm as well, from that little slap around the head he gave me on the way to the ring.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, welcome home to Scotland, the champion, Kevin Anderson!
Well, just look at the support for Kevin Anderson. This isn't his hometown, he's from Fife, the area which is about to produce our next Prime Minister, Gordon Brown. From Methil, Kevin Anderson, 24, and he's been in some momentous scraps lately. The British Boxing Board of Control's Fight of the Year last year against Young Muttley, when he turned it all around to win the British title. And then the controversial and close defeat against Ali Numbembe when he lost his Commonwealth crown. He still thinks he won that, other people don't. But there's no doubt about it, he's at home tonight, all right. How much is his crowd worth?
Well, it's a very good crowd for him. But he's got a tough test in front of him. This will tell what he's all about.
Tale of the tape for this fight tonight. Anderson, much younger, by 11 years, in fact. Magee's a bit taller. He's a southpaw counter-puncher, as Ricky Hatton found out. Anderson bang on the limit. Magee a little bit inside. Slight reach advantage, nothing much for Magee. Magee's been a professional since Kevin Anderson was 12 years old, back to 1995. He's had more fights at a much, much higher level, it has to be said. He's fought four rounds, and I think he has the edge in power as well. But that age, that's against him, and he has lost to Takaloo, Magee, in recent times. Good fight here for the classic British welterweight crown.
Ladies and gentlemen, a very warm welcome to the Civic Centre here in Motherwell, Scotland, for tonight's British Championship Boxing, brought to you by Tommy Gilmore and Barry Hearn for Matchroom Sport. Sponsored here by PartyPoker.com, the world's largest poker room. 12 rounds of boxing for the British Welterweight Championship, live and exclusive here on Sky Sports. You've joined us, and it's Friday Fight Night. All the officials have been appointed by the British Boxing Board of Control here present with us at ringside. Steward in charge of the action is Mr. Bernard Connolly, joined by Derry Traynor. Three scoring judges: Ian John Lewis of Gillingham, England; John Keane of Wellingborough, England; and Vic Lachlan of Paisley, Scotland. The referee in charge of the action from Doncaster, England, is Mr. Howard Foster. They are the officials. Now let's meet the contestants. Firstly, and introducing to you the challenger fighting out of the red corner, wearing the green, white, and gold trunks. 10 stone, 6 pounds, 12 ounces, with a 32-fight record, 27 wins, 20 inside the scheduled distance, and only 5 defeats coming to the ring. As the former Commonwealth Light Welterweight Champion from beautiful Belfast, Northern Ireland, it's Eamonn Magee! And now, ladies and gentlemen, it's the champion. He's fighting out of the blue corner. He's wearing the white and red trunks, weighing in at 10 stone 7. 19 fight record, 18 wins, 11 inside the scheduled distance, and just one defeat. He makes his first defense. He is the reigning and defending British welterweight champion from Methil in the Kingdom of Fife, Scotland. It's Kevin Anderson. So, sports fans and Sky Sports fans, here on Friday Fight Night, let's get the action underway with 12 rounds of boxing for the British Welterweight Championship and the coveted Lonsdale belt.
Okay, lads, spoke to you both in the dressing room. You both know I expect. Keep it clean, break straight away when told. Both of you watch your heads. Good luck to you both. Touch gloves. Good luck, lads.
Kevin Anderson with a new trainer for this fight, Bob Shannon, for the first time, though. Bob says he hasn't really had enough time with Anderson to affect things too much, just a few tactical things. Magee, who's been with John Breen all the way through, an intimidating presence in the ring. Eamonn Magee, fringe world-class fighter, as he proved against Ricky Hatton, the only man to floor Hatton with that terrific right hand where they met in the first round of their contest. He shook him up in the second, too. Anderson will be looking to apply pressure, but educated pressure, he hopes, not in straight lines, otherwise that might just play into Magee's hands.
Yes, Anderson is going to have to concentrate on his defense. He's going to have to tug off very tight as he tries to force this fight.
One thing Anderson can't afford to do is dive in unthinkingly. Not with this guy, because he has the capability to take you out. Magee, who's coming from Belfast, tough upbringing where he was stabbed in the neck, shot a couple of times, and then in a street attack, broke his leg in two places, had his knees smashed up, life-threatening blood clots. It's a wonder he's here at all.
Yes, it is. He's a tough character, and nothing's really going to faze him in the ring. But this is really a test of the character of Anderson. He's the young man, and he's the one that's at the beginning of what could be a good career. It's really how he handles the pressure.
Good body shot from Anderson. That was the kind of thing he'll be looking to do in this fight. Because Magee spent most of his career down at light welterweight. He's up at welterweight here. That might just be a factor too. Good left hand from Anderson there. Question with him a bit, Glenn, is this is pretty soon after the disappointing defeat he had against Numbembe, controversial though it was, and it's a tough one to come back to, isn't it?
Yes, it is. It's all about preparation and, you know, temperament, how he's conditioned his mind to bounce back from that loss. Often it can take an awful lot out of a fighter. Sometimes it's just what a fighter needed. Just makes them just get right on edge again. So it's a very, very important fight for Kevin Anderson.
And if he wins it, it would be a notable scalp on his record. A real confidence restorer. Good body shot from him. He started fast. I think at the moment, Nick, he's just having trouble with the hand speed of Anderson.
Yep, and I think, you know, he's got a bit of power. Anderson as well seems quite strong. Looking to come forward for most of the first round.
How much mobility does Magee have? And that was definitely Anderson's opening session. Bob Shannon in the corner there with Anderson. Rav Crockett is the old amateur trainer that Anderson's been with for a long time as well, but Shannon's come in now for this fight. They've been working together over long weekends down in Manchester. White trunks Anderson, Kevin Anderson from Methelin Fife, defending his British welterweight crown, which he won in such memorable fashion against Young Muttley in a terrific stormer of a fight down in the Midlands.
Bob Shannon asking Anderson just to move the head. Sometimes he does keep the head a little still, and I don't think he can afford to do so against Magee.
Slow out of the blocks tonight, Eamonn Magee. Anderson's going to just have to be cute, but the early signs are that the speed of his hands could be a problem for Eamonn Magee. To pick a left hand there, as Magee hits hard as well, sneaking little right hand as well. He ended up losing on points to Ricky Hatton on that famous night we were talking about. Also been by Oktay Erkal, the world-class fighter based in Germany. Paul Burke, that was a ridiculous decision, which he did avenge. Good shots from Magee, that's more like it. Two southpaw leads, then whipped home the left hand. You don't want to be taking too many of those from this guy.
No, he's got to use that southpaw stance to good effect. Really throw that right-hand jab hard and then look to bring the left right through the middle. Sometimes a bit square on, Anderson.
Just finding his rhythm, Magee, in the second round. Starting to slip some of these punches as well. He's mixed with the best. He's beaten Shane Neary. That was a close one. John Thaxton, Paul Burke, few Africans in five Commonwealth title defences. Oh, great right hand from Anderson. And that shook up Magee a little. He smiles, leers through the gumshoe, but that was a terrific shot from the Scot.
Yes, and I think that's where the speed of Anderson was shown there. There were nice, quick shots that surprised Magee.
Sharp work from Anderson.
Well, that proves that the concentration is there. He was very quick back with those shots, Anderson.
It was a good comeback, just as Magee was beginning to establish some kind of a rhythm. Whips in that left hand again, and that's a heavier one that lands.
Just waiting a little bit long, Magee, and he has to take a shot.
The old poker face of Eamonn Magee, not there tonight. Twice he's reacted when those rights have landed. He's not slipping some of the shots he used to. I think that is a sign that he may be not quite as sharp as he was at his peak. Well, Eamonn Magee said before this fight, I'll take Anderson to school tonight, and he won't be long in the classroom either. But it's not turning out quite like that early, is it, Glenn?
No, he's not getting it his way at all, Eamonn Magee. He started very sharp, come back with a good right hand and left hook there. And that will just be starting to unsettle Magee a little bit.
Anderson, who says, if I lose this one, I can't go back fighting six rounders for peanuts. I've got to win. Some interpreted that as pretty negative talk from him. Maybe it was just being realistic. He knows he's got nowhere to go. And at 24, this is a must-win fight. It is too, really, for Magee, because he's out of the big league if he loses tonight, I think.
Yeah, Magee needs this. Needs a win here to get himself back in, get himself in and move up from here. The launch pad, it could be late in the career of Magee.
There's another stiff left hand landed by Anderson in that exchange as well. Because one of the things that happens to fighters as they get a bit older is the reflexes dull, don't they, a little?
Yeah, they just haven't got the same sort of mobility and movement, and the reflexes, as you say, just dull, and you take more shots.
Magee looking to get a bit more serious, looking to force Anderson back this time. And that grimace on his face that we've seen 1,000 times down the years. I think the question with Anderson is, he's had less than 20 fights. Was he ready for somebody as good as Magee if Magee was somewhere near his best?
Well, I think Magee can't afford to allow Anderson to come forward. I think that's where Anderson will just start rolling along, get the momentum, getting shots off.
Magee has to start pushing him on the back foot. We saw against Numembe, he had success when he did that.
I think he's trying to do that, Magee. I think his boxing brain will have worked that out. Another right hand on the counter there from Magee. Been a bit more accurate and busy in this third round, his best so far. Madison gets there with the right hand and a little chopping left too. He's learned plenty in these championship fights he's been having lately. He's a gritty kind of customer. He proved that against young Muttley because he really rescued that from nowhere.
Yep, showing good character. Anderson still looking to come forward, landing a couple of eye-catching punches. Nice one to the body there.
Getting the southpaw jab into play here, though, Magee, in this round, maybe significantly. If he can do that, he can maybe stop Anderson coming at him. Maybe. Good left now, though, from Anderson. This is a good fight so far, fascinatingly poised.
There's another good short little right hand from Anderson. Both having successes in this round.
I thought Magee won his first round there myself.
More British title action next week on Friday Fight Night. We're at London's XL Arena as Tony Oakey gets an unexpected title chance. He faces Steve Spartacus for the vacant British light heavyweight title. That's Friday, May the 18th, 10 p.m. on Sky Sports 2.
We're in Motherwell tonight, where Ian St John used to play at centre forward for the local team at Fir Park, just across the road. Fourth round here. Eamonn Magee, the southpaw from Belfast, has been around this business, it seems, forever now. He's 35, 11 years older than the man in front of him, Kevin Anderson, the reigning British welterweight champion. Good body shot from Anderson. He talked to him there, Magee, and came in with a fierce-looking left hand at the end of it all.
Showing good fast hands, Anderson. Been quite impressive here. So far, concentration's good. Defence is good.
But the most significant chapters in this story may yet be untold. You'd think a long fight would suit Anderson, wouldn't you, really, as the younger man? But who knows?
There's another long right hand from Anderson. This is the more eye-catching of the punches.
Magee, again, just looking to unsettle him with repeated use of that right lead.
The problem for Magee, Ian, he's pouring with that jab. He needs to really put that in and push the head back with some power. You know, Anderson's just going to walk through that like he did there and got the left hook on.
He's got the left hand cocked, ready for use, Magee. If he sees a gap, he'll thump that power punch home. Counter-punching display again, this from Magee. He's happy doing that, though. Great support for Anderson in here. He couldn't wish for better. None of the seats in here are more than about 15 yards from the ring. This really does feel like some kind of intimidating cage.
Yeah, it's good atmosphere here. Anderson copied well with the experienced Magee in front of him. And Anderson has adopted a lot more head movement, side-to-side movement, which is just stopping Magee landing that jab.
And just quite cleverly switching the angle of attack, too, I've noticed, Anderson. He's thinking about this. This is what they've been working on with Bob Shannon down in Manchester.
But then when he throws a combination like that, he's the one that gets through. Anderson's round.
I've heard that.
Bob Shannon, who likes to take his boxers for big fell runs, he hasn't done that with Anderson.
There, it's Anderson, good body shot. Magee covering up, getting through to catch a few of them, but Anderson still, he's the one that's landing the better punches.
Reigning champion, Kevin Anderson of Scotland in the white trunks here. Probably ahead early on here, after four. Good sharp left hand from Eamonn Magee. And a nice countering right as well, as Anderson tried to close in on.
Yep, that was a good single shot, but he's going to need more than that. He's got to try and unsettle Anderson. Still would like to see him try and push Anderson on the back foot.
Can he do that? Anderson's pretty strong, quite bull-like. Likes to apply pressure when he can. And Magee doesn't have the speed that young Muttley brought to the occasion when the two fought. And that speed, combined with some extra power, seemed to really trouble Anderson that night. He was shaken up a few times.
He's 11 years older, and you know he's operated most of his career at the younger weight, and that's pretty significant, Ian.
It's a good effort this from Anderson so far. He's coping with the special problems that Magee serves well, and came up with a right hand counter of his own on that occasion. Still a long time left in the fight, though. He could twist this way and that. This one.
Falling short with that jab, that's been a bit of a disappointment. You want to see him get through with that southpaw jab, Magee.
He's just pouring with it, there's no authority about it. The left hand had a little more.
Bring it up, baby. Bring it up.
Anderson made to miss. Magee got himself out of trouble.
Very, very cagey, Magee. Always looking for a counter he can come back with, but he's just a little bit too quick at this moment, Anderson.
That's a good shot from Magee. Got a wee bit more menace into those punches, and then makes Anderson miss. Anderson tries to pull him against the ropes, and Magee waves him in again. Again, they both land with right hands. So this is a famous weight division and a famous title. Ted Kidd Lewis, perhaps the greatest British boxer of any weight, held this title a long time ago. Eddie Thomas, who went on to become a great trainer, 1949 to 51. There was Brian Curvis later, and then John H. Tracy, who became a world champion, that great win over Jose Napoles in Mexico. Kirkland Lang, who the gifted one, he called himself, in those two great fights with Colin Jones, beaten both times after dominating. Lloyd Hannigan, who famously beat Don Curry in Atlantic City for the world title. And more latterly, Gary Jacobs from Scotland from 1992 to 93. In fact, the first Scot ever to hold the British welterweight title was Tommy Milligan, who came from 3 miles up the road from here at Wishaw in 1924. Here's round six of this one. Anderson probably ahead. And one of the things here, Glenn, is if the rounds are a bit tight, Anderson probably would get the nod because he's the one making the fight most of the time.
Well, that doesn't always work, as it didn't with Oscar De La Hoya. You know, we thought he was making the fight, and they didn't score it that way.
Well, that's one interpretation. That's another debate.
There's not a great deal in these rounds for me. It's just nicking them, Anderson, with a little bit of the cleaner work. Just punch picking better. And I think it's going to take a big effort for Magee to take the play away.
Will his extra experience count? That was a good left hand. Snappy shot and another one. That sent the sweat spraying from Anderson's face.
Much better for Magee. The clash heads as well there. That might unsettle Anderson after he just took two good left hands.
As Magee knows all about these championship occasions. A bit more than Anderson does, who's just started really at this kind of level in recent fights.
If Anderson doesn't make a significant breakthrough, will he run out of ideas a little bit? Very experienced Magee.
The right hand gets through, that'll lift Anderson, but it was his first success of the round. He brought another one of those smiles through the gum shield from Magee, as if to say, you might have landed, but you didn't hurt me. Again, he gets through. Bit of blood around the head coming from somewhere of Magee. Not much of it, as a cracking right hand from the champion, Anderson.
Well, he started this round better, Magee, with his left, but it's Anderson's coming back with his right.
Body and head, Eamonn, come on!
Both of them landed, and maybe Anderson to his leg. Heavier shot. And again, he gets through to Magee, and then with a body shot as well. He's making this an uncomfortable night for the man from Northern Ireland.
Yeah, brings a smile across the face from Magee, but that was because he got hit with a couple of shots.
Any idea that Magee had that he'd have too much class for Anderson is going out of the window a little bit at the moment. Anderson's been up to the job.
Yep, the youngster from Fife doing pretty well here.
Listen, you
should see where the blood's coming from.
You should have been over to your left. You stood in front of him, you didn't even...
Just a cut on the head, I think. For yep. Magee.
Magee starting quite well at the beginning of the round, and then there was that nasty head clash.
Yeah, that was what caused it. And it, you can see the blood there, and that's that cracking right back from Anderson. He'd had a couple of those after Magee had started the round fast.
He had, he started well, but Anderson just took the play away, took the eye towards the end of the round, putting Magee on the back foot, and I'm just nicking these rounds in Anderson's favour. Magee needs to do something pretty big if he's going to sway the tide.
Back to work, there's Glenn's card for you so far.
Yep, very little I give to Magee, but the rounds are very close, I might add.
I've got it a bit closer than that, at 59-56 to Anderson. Second half of the fight now. Magee has been boxing since he was 5 years old when his mother sent him to the gym. He said you only had to go to the street corner where I come from to have a fight. And quite often he did.
Got to up the work rate, Magee. He's got to start throwing those straight right and left, straight down the middle.
You see, he hasn't been able to take control at any stage really yet.
No, he's had little flashes when he's done some good work, but the single eye-catching punches have come from Anderson.
Well, every time he's tried to assert himself, Anderson's come back with something like that. That's really good tactics. Couple of body shots, then away again.
Yeah. Doesn't give the older Magee time to react.
Left uppercut,
One, two, three, punches. Didn't all land cleanly, but it's impressive again. The hand speed working well tonight for Anderson. He's just making Magee look a tad ponderous by comparison.
You've got to work, Eamonn.
Some of these jabs from Magee, getting that punch working a little bit.
And it was Anderson who was looking to play the counter-puncher. He's mixing it up pretty well here. Still burning with indignation. He didn't think he deserved to lose his title to Ali Numbebi. It was a close fight, and those who believe that the championship should be ripped away were in Anderson's side that night. Others thought Numbebi deserved it. Single jabs again. He can't keep Anderson off him, though. Anderson giving every sign that he might be a more effective pro than he was in the amateurs. He only made a quarter-finals in the Commonwealth Games in 2002. Signs that he might be improving. As I know Bob Shannon, his new trainer, feels he could be a fitter and more cut than he is.
Yeah, I know they said that, but he's doing well here.
Punches landed, shows that Anderson has landed 14 more so far, and he's been more accurate with the punches as well. Magee's thrown more, interesting that.
Yes, that is interesting, because he doesn't seem to have. Anderson seems to have been the busier, you know, but it's eye-catching stuff like that. You know, this is really a thinking fight, and just doing that little bit better in most of these rounds for me, Anderson.
I think Bob Shannon there himself sees this as a big night in his training career, though he hasn't had Anderson for the whole build-up, the whole 8 to 10 weeks that he'd like. Back they go to work. I think it's almost certain that Anderson would be ahead. We don't like to second guess the three judges, but it looks that way anyway. This is the eighth round of it. It's just a feeling that Magee needs a big finish in the fight. Range, one, two, three times with his right lead, Eamonn Magee.
Yep, I think that's been a lot of what he's done, Magee. He's thrown that jab, maybe further back, they think that's landing, but he's caught most of them on the gloves, Anderson.
Quite clever raiding tactics from Anderson, who's not hanging around when he does get close. He whips off a couple of punches and then doesn't hang around to get the counter. Smart strategy, well thought out, and in the main, fairly well executed so far, Glenn.
Yep. Just dropped off a little bit himself this round, Anderson.
Covered up well, Anderson. Now he took one around the top of the head from Magee. Can the older man sustain some pressure? Take the eye of the judges, take control of a round.
Yeah, just missing more, Anderson. Maybe he's just starting to feel it a little bit himself. He's just dropped off the boil a little bit.
Slightly circumspect, Magee waiting, just getting off with those single jabs, not much more. A little ragged this round, in all honesty. He's had to take that right hand all night tonight, hasn't he, Magee?
Yep, he's been open for that one, and he hasn't been as effective with his left, although Anderson has just been quieter in this round, and he's missed more than ever before.
Can't afford to fade in the fight, though, Anderson. Good body shot from Magee. Anderson backs off a little, having taken that one. Interesting.
He went to sleep in that run, and I ain't happy about that. Are you the old man? Are you the 35-year-old? You look like it to me. When I was looking at you, I thought you were the 35-year-old, not the 24-year-old. You're going to go out there now and show them what you're worth. Are you the champion? Well, do you want to stay champion? Well, you better start performing and get sharper, get in the water. Are you listening? I ain't happy. You're letting back in the fight. So you get in there, use your jabs and feint. You work for every minute of this round. Listening.
Well, they think he's dropped off the pace. That's interesting, because I think they read that round kind of like you did, Glenn.
Yeah, I just think he wasn't as sharp. He didn't seem the concentration was there, the momentum was there. And I think they're worried that the shape of the fight will start to change from here. Need to keep him focused.
Let's go into that corner now. Bob Shannon is talking to Ed Robinson.
Bob, how happy are you with Kevin's performance so far?
Well, he had a laser round in that round, and I really told him off. I've told him, to me, he looked like the older man in that round, and I've just told him off about it. He's got to go out there, use his agility, use his speed, pressing the second half of the fight, so now, hopefully, we're going to take over. I'll give him a good telling off, told him to get on with it and get his sharpness back. This is what I need from him, you know, the belief.
Thanks, Bob.
Looks like Anderson heeded the warning there, judged by that nice assault from after quite a good start from Magee in the round as well. He's just starting to get a bit more authority into his jab. Eamonn Magee maybe growing in confidence, maybe he thinks the late rounds could work for him.
Well, I think they're both starting to slow a little bit. And Bob Shannon realises that he needs to motivate Anderson. He's getting hit a bit more in the exchanges, Anderson. Still getting his own punches off.
Moving on towards what the Americans like to call the championship rounds now. Who's got it in the finishing straight?
Well, I don't think you'll find Eamonn Magee wanting if it's down to grit and determination. Pretty tough customer.
Just a question at 35. Does the fire still burn quite as brightly? Does he want it quite as much as he did as a kid coming through?
Well, that's interesting. At the end of a career, it's always so much harder. You've had the dreams, you haven't realized it as you wanted to, and it's much tougher to try and think of that again.
Good right hand comes in from Anderson. Not much between them, I'd say, in this session so far. Last minute of the round. Good exchanges. If anything, they've just upped the tempo in the last half a minute or so.
Well, I think the work will get more exciting because as they get tired, they're going to stand around. But for me, he's missing more now, Anderson, and Magee's connecting more.
Is the old war horse just clawing his way back more seriously into the argument? He comes back and has the last word in that exchange with that right hand, and that's a thumping left hand right through the middle. Nice and sharp now, Magee.
This is the stage in the fight also where Anderson might start to have some doubts.
Just a crisper work from Magee at this stage. He's just found the range a little better.
Yeah, but I think the speed of Anderson troubled him early on, beating him to the punch. Now he's slowed down that little bit. He's finding Anderson easy to hit.
Probably Magee's round. Probably.
Yeah, pretty helpful.
Noted. Belfast trainer John Breen in the corner.
You can't have a four and two punch any better. You can't have a four and two punch.
No.
There's the better counter from Magee. He's trying to get shots off there. That time Anderson got through with a decent left. But he's just slowing down slightly, Anderson. Easier to hit, and he's missing with more punches now.
Wasn't a lot in that last round, but the feeling was that Magee had done enough of his Christmas punching. He might be squeezing it up a bit on the cards. 10th round, 3 to go here. White Trunks with the red stripe down the side, the defending British welterweight champion, Kevin Anderson. Let's go into Magee's corner. Trainer John Breen is with Ed.
Well, John, is Eamonn behind in this fight?
I think he may be a round or two behind, but we're in Glasgow, so we don't know. We're in Red Scar or Scotland, so...
Has he still got it in him at 35 to pick up the pace now?
He's still got the desire he wants. He said, I'm going to go forward. I should go forward this turn.
Can he stop Kevin Anderson?
I think he can. If he gets a couple of good shots on, he can do it.
Thank you.
Confident still, but interesting, they think he's behind, as we do. Maybe by a couple of points. Seems to be the general ringside consensus at the moment.
But he's starting to edge his way forward more ominously, isn't he, Magee?
Can he pull this around? Is Anderson starting to lose a bit of fizz? He's starting to get hit more, not so much head movement, and not quite so much coming back. It's Magee doing more of the leading now. Not that time.
Yeah, he caught that one on the gloves, but Magee.
Ooh. Bit of menace about that from Eamonn Magee. That was reminiscent of some former times in his career. High class operator. Was so disappointed he didn't get to the Barcelona Olympics. That's why he turned pro. Could walk onto a right hand there from Anderson. Anderson, who said before this fight, if Magee wants a war, I'll outlast him. Good tussle, this one. And we still quite don't know the destiny. There's what Anderson was doing earlier in the fight, the fast right hands that Magee hasn't really been able to get out of the way of.
Well, McGee's really got to start throwing some punches now. He seems to be turning it around a little bit, but he needs an awful lot more. He's got to win these rounds big.
He may have to win the final three to turn the fight around. We'll see. Anderson's picked it up a little more in this session. Maybe he's starting to see the finishing post just looming up on the horizon.
Yeah, maybe just feeling that second wind. Just picked it up, few good right hands.
Magee started this round well. Anderson's come back at him. Some of these rounds are close, aren't they?
Yes, some of them have been very close. Not a lot of punches in them.
Dead level on headshots so far, 69 apiece. More to the body from Anderson, who's landed, according to our computer statisticians, significantly more overall. Anderson has been particularly effective tonight with the right hand.
Yep, later in the round he pulled a few single rights out. Magee got off with some good shots early on in the round. Pretty tight, but just the feel to me that Magee is just a bit stronger, just trying to edge him his way back.
Get your head on it now, come on.
I just have a feeling that Magee needs to do a little more than he's doing if he's going to pull this one around. He's away from home here, and he is the challenger.
Yep. Well, he knows that, so he knows he's got to really try hard. Anderson knows he lost it at home in a title fight.
It would break his heart if that was to happen again. He has to make sure it doesn't by being busy, busy, busy in these last two sessions. Just wanted a bit cleaner, I think. Howard Foster. Good right hand again from Anderson, who's looking to get to the body. Magee lasting the pace well. He says he's been in the gym since Christmas preparing for this. He had a fight in February as well, a low-key effort.
But noticeably coming forward more and more, Magee. Good little barrage of punches from him there.
Yeah, first combination punches, but look at Anderson come back. Anderson mustn't get careless here. He's looking to go to work. Terrific exchange. First Magee, then Anderson with punches in bunches.
Just sticking his chin out a little bit there.
Whoa, big Anderson. Right, Anderson.
I get the feeling Magee senses Anderson just starting to weaken a little bit, the way he's coming forward.
He's looking to pick it up late on here, Magee. Anderson refuses to be dominated, though, much to his credit.
Well, we've seen him show great courage before in the young Muttley fight. Came back, big score, a stoppage win, and a great fight.
No one's ever stopped Eamonn Magee in his whole career.
Good right hand, shot to the body as well from Magee.
Almost a question of who do you like in this round. Oh, right hand! Beautiful shot from Anderson. Magee on the floor, a very rare sight. It was a great shot. And that right hand that's worked all night for Kevin Anderson has really done the trick there. And that might have been the decisive moment. Magee all over the place for a moment here.
Yep, Anderson really on top now, rubbing the head back. He sees the finish. He's going for it.
Last half minute of the round, Magee nades the bell. He actually applauded the punch like an old pro. Great shot, and he nodded to the corner to Eamonn Magee, as if to say, yeah, caught good and proper.
Yeah, he looks tired. He looks empty. The gas looks empty. Magee.
Brilliant stuff, really, from Kevin Anderson. Gumshields come out. They might have just there. Now, that might be an old pro's trick. That might be an old pro's trick. Buy a bit of time. I think it was.
Yeah, the referee let go on for a little while, and then when they come together, decided to put it back in.
Just gave Magee a little respite at a key moment. The bell comes anyway, but Anderson might have sealed it there with that knockdown in the 11th round.
Well, there's that beautiful right hand. He tried to get himself set to throw his own shot, Magee. He gives a smile, a wry smile, and even applauded the shot. But it was a really good response from Kevin Anderson as Eamonn Magee started to look to get a foothold in the fight. He come back with a punch like that.
Well, we're going through the records. We can't remember. I can't remember Eamonn Magee ever being on the floor before. Can you?
No, I can't remember. He's always had a very good chin.
He's probably got to the stage now where a fading Eamonn Magee needs a knockout here, I'd say. Both of them exchanged words of mutual respect. And I think it's fair to say that Kevin Anderson has proved himself a little better than Eamonn Magee suspected tonight. Fair?
Yep. So far he's answered the questions. He's kept it up. Looked to be slipping a little bit in the late rounds, but he's come back full of fire.
The win over young Muttley was a dramatic one for Kevin Anderson, but I'd say if he does go on to secure the victory here, it would be the best night of his pro career so far, bearing in mind the pedigree of the opposition.
Yes, very much so. Terrific win. But it's not over yet.
He's finishing big, Anderson here, full of confidence. He might be a different fighter, you know, after this. This could work wonders for Kevin Anderson.
Yep, I think this could be a real confidence builder.
I don't want to knock Anderson either, but there are one or two stories around the game that he hasn't been perhaps the most dedicated or fittest of fighters. I think Shannon will get him fitter, you know, in the future as well, and he'll be better for that.
Well, he's had a look in other gyms now at how they train, what their level of fitness is, and maybe that's come as a bit of a surprise to him.
This has been a good performance. He just has to see it through. Now McGee digs in body shots here, still trying to turn the thing around in what the last half of the last round.
Yes, the fiery McGee still trying hard. Spitting out defiance to the end.
He's trying everything he knows, McGee, but maybe at this stage of his career he doesn't quite know enough for the fresher, more ambitious fighter. A fighter who's moved to another level perhaps tonight too, with a smart strategic display too.
Keeping tucked up, using decent defense in the closing stages now, Anderson.
And he's boxing like he thinks he has it in the bag, not doing too much, just staying out of trouble as much as he can. On the balls of his feet, mobile. They think they're in a points lead, and they might not be wrong. No. History proves, doesn't it, that we should never, ever take anything for granted.
No, most definitely not. But I think that the knockdown will have sealed his victory here.
Just a little jab. McGee's probably done most of the pressing in this last round, and he's probably won the last round, but I don't think it'll be enough. That might be a glory night for Kevin Anderson. The crowd here think so. McGee is not too bullish. I think he believes in his heart of hearts he didn't do enough there. And I thought tonight Kevin Anderson in the main was superb. That was an excellent effort from him, and he proved really that he can fight up at a higher level at welterweight. That's not the look of a man who believes he's pulled off a big win, is it?
No, I don't think so. I think he knows, just didn't quite have enough. He's on 35-year-old legs, probably at the closing stages of a career. But for me, Anderson, just a sharper throughout, and a four-point winner on my card.
I've got it 116-113.
So, both you watch your heads. Good luck to you both.
Highlights from the fight. Anderson very aggressive early on. McGee did a bit better, maybe in the third.
Yeah, but Anderson just that little bit cleaner punch, and you know, he just kept getting the shots on, just doing a little bit more. But as it went on, McGee just started to turn the corner a little bit, then started to get on top.
You just wondered if he was going to start clawing it back, McGee. But Anderson seemed to find a second win, and then there was a big moment in the 11th, the decisive moment. That McGee down for what we believe was the first knockdown in his career. We'll get it officially in a moment or two. John Keane, Ian John Lewis, Victor Lachlan, the Scottish referee. There's the final printout on the punches. More landed by Anderson, 25 more, and a better success rate, which seems to underline how we've got it scored at ringside here. But we need this officially, don't we? They look confident. We'll find out now.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 12 championship rounds of boxing, the judges' scorecards read as follows. Judge Victor Lachlan scores the contest 110-119. Judge John Keane 111-118. Judge Ian John Lewis 110-117. All three judges are in favour of And still, the British welterweight champion from the Kingdom of Fife, Scotland, Kevin Anderson.
No ifs and buts. Very
and
big margins
and
on the cards, bigger than Glenn and I had ever ringside, I must say.
For
Kevin Anderson, the best night of his career, he's still
Magee.
The British welterweight champion.
And now to present the coveted Lonsdale belt.
Glory, glory, now then for Scottish boxing. Kevin Anderson retaining his title with that points victory over Eamonn Magee. We'll get the thoughts of Anderson's countryman.
Well, Kevin, still British champion. How satisfying a win was that? And what do you think of your performance?
Oh, that was a great one. I mean, they're going about... Though they remember Eamonn Magee is putting Ricky Hatton, doing Ricky Hatton's best boxer in the world at light welter. So they go in and drop him and win widely on points is a great win for me over Magee.
What was the key tonight?
The key was just getting his head right. I mean, for a few fights, my head's just not been right, maybe training and that. But I made the move, went down to Bubsy, and I couldn't get better sparring and training in the country than I was getting down there. And it just going in and seeing different champions training, guys trying to get what you've got, and it's just a buzz in itself walking into a gym like that, and it just rubbed off on me.
How much of a difference did that make in the build-up to this fight?
Oh, definitely. I mean, it was all new to us when we turned pro with Ab. We were top of the tree, but it was at amateurs, and it's a new ball game when we went to pros, and it took a while to settle in. And as you've seen there, I've done the 12 rounds easy there. I was on my toes the whole 12 rounds. I was packing my punches. My guard was a bit better. I never took too many clean shots. So it was 100% improvement. And that was only with a couple of weeks I worked with Bob.
Well, let's bring in your new trainer, Bob Shannon. Yeah. How did you rate Kevin's performance?
I was really pleased with him. You know, only having a couple of weeks with him, I was worried going into the fight because I wanted it into June. But what a performance. And he can only get better from now on.
To become the first man to put Eamonn Magee down as well in the 11th round.
Well, that's I mean, it's a great achievement going in with a guy like Magee's experience. I mean, everybody remembers what he done to Ricky Hatton, and Ricky Hatton's the best in the world. So to go in there and win comfortable and put him down is a great achievement, and that's a great boost for my career.
Well done tonight.